Start of our second semifinal. Bastian Steger to serve. Blachek to receive. This will be totally different than the first one. The offense and defensive save. And Jonas, this will be an offensive firework. Backhand to backhand. A lot of play. Steger with a quick 3-0 lead. Loop to loop, and then down the line with the backhand. Beautiful play by Blachek to keep that ball in play on that second one with the backhand. It's his favorite play. They open up with that loop cross court, and Luchon can take that down the line with the counter loop. Very good at that. And he's an intense player. Down 3-0, gets four quick ones. A lot of technique here, folks. Beautiful. There's that down the line loop again. I don't know how he does it, but that's his favorite shot. Gets that shoulder open and take the ball late right down the line. Steger side under serve. Re-loop by Blachek. Very aggressive. And quickly, six in a row. After a slow start by Blachek, he runs six straight. Make it seven. You have to watch the technique, folks. That beautiful return of serve. And the thing about Blachek, I told you earlier, Matt, I love his intensity, and he's always hopping. And he's always giving it his all. I mean, look at that, taking the ball early, and boom! Over his career, I remember him knocking off some big Chinese players and other players, and takes that ball quick. He's like a fireplug. 7-4. Underspin serve, opening. Bastian can't push it down. Bastian Steger played in the Euro-Asia matches in China just last week. A lot of flying, but you know he's in top shape. He's not going into those tournaments without being in top shape. He's getting spanked in game one, 4-9. Blachek, he doesn't play on the Pro Tour so much. Plays professionally at a club. He's probably pretty excited about playing in a real tournament where he can play, whereas Bastian, you know, he plays so many. He just played the Euro-Asia matches, he's got to play the German Bundesliga and playing for the German national team. Luchon is somewhat semi-retired, doesn't play for the Polish team anymore, but you can see he's still one heck of a player. Always admired his intensity, always admired his take the ball early, and a great sportsman, really. Never quite won the big titles, even though he sure did come close. Sort of one of the best players you never heard of. Steger, very known for his backhand play. You can see that quick backhand, but Blachek, he hasn't given him the backhand. He's keeping a lot of the balls on the forehand side. Steger's forehand is a funny looking ball where he takes that front arm and turns it, and that's because he favors the backhand so much he's late on the forehand, and he's developed a little bit of a hitch there. Oh, just missed the banana. No fruit in table tennis. Side under serve, excellent return by Steger. The short game, I'm sure Steger is going to have a very good short game playing with Timo Boll and the German team. You got to have a short game. One of the best lobbers in the world, Bastian Steger. Let's see him do it. Yes, sirree. He is unbelievable as a lob. Oh, just missed the edge. He puts a little side spin on that lob too, which sort of draws the ball back to him. Side top. You get caught in going for that banana, you get the racket too low, and that topspin ball will sail long. Happens a lot. It's a little bit easier to loop the under. Blowout in game one, and we're heading for another one in game two. But different player, and that's that backhand of Steger. An absolute winner. I can even see from here his grip. Woo! Bingo. Oh, yeah. Oh! And Blažek can hit that ball too, man. He's pounding that thing. Oh, funky little ball. Looked like it was going to loop it, and then he went to push it, and he sort of mishit it. Got a quick free one. Man, that backhand receive has let him down this game. Racket was wet. Nice counter loop by Bastian. 9-5. Match almost all even. Look at that backhand play. Beautiful backhand, but missed the forehand counter. Seven, danger, danger. A couple loose points. One game each. Second semifinal, Heisen, Chicago International Table Tennis Open. Lucjan Blažek, 11-4, 8-11. Two very aggressive receives there by Lucjan. Backhand topspin, forehand flip. Quick 2-0 lead. Both these players favoring the hook serve. Not that time, there's the pendulum. Backhand to backhand play. Both these guys love that quick backhand right over the top. That's sort of the new shot in table tennis. The game is always evolving. You have the banana receive is really the number one thing, but then also the quick backhand right at the table, using the wrist mostly. Chinese are the best at it, of course. Really high serve there is going to cost them. I don't know if you can see that, folks, on the video, but that was an incredible drop shot. A backhand loop on the run from way back. And Luchan made up his mind real early, and he actually stuck that drop shot in there. That was brilliant. Got the crowd smiling, even the players. That's the kind of shot you really can appreciate. And the backhand over the top again. Bastian able to put some side spin on that return. You can see their serves are so short and tight and low. Nice block right down the middle. Anytime you get a chance to go to the body, block to the body, loop to the body, get a guy making the switch. That's the backhand Luchan's been looking for, the one and go inside out. He's very good at that. Inside out on backhand, inside out on forehand, stands real square to the table. Polish players have always been known for great backhands. Andre Gruba and Kucharski. Oh. Two serves in a row cost them. Second one looked like a little bit of a bad bounce, but 6-4 quickly goes to 8-4. 4-8. Oh, that's a funky forehand there. That little crossing motion. That's what gets him in trouble and has kept him away from being an elite player. Which he is, let me say that, Steger is definitely an elite player, but he has not really won many titles, has not been able to win many big tournaments, because technically his forehand is just not a real salute. It's very unique, but it's limited. And 11-4 for Blaszczyk, 2-1, Giannis in the final. Look at that, 11-4, 8-11, 11-4. It seems like on this side of the table, something's going on. Like the players have been playing really well on this side. It seemed like it all day. I've watched all the matches, all four quarterfinals in the first semi. It just seems like that. Probably no real difference. But maybe just coincidence. Let's see if Steger can continue the run of players on this side. So actually in this match, the player on this side has won fairly easily all three games. Right, quickly, the side holds true. Down the line, try to get that down the line special. First one he's missed in a while. Oh, looks a little bit messed up here. I don't know, he got a towel and was doing something before this game. And again, this side of the table dominating play. Big spin on that ball. You see that thing jump off the racket? Wow, I called that right. Every once in a while I get it right. This side of the table, something's going on. Something's going on this side. It seems it's a little more than, gotta be a little bit more than coincidence that the scores are so different. Even the match I played last night to get into the quarterfinals, I played on this side of the table where Blaszczyk is right now. And I lost in deuce and nine. And on the other side of the table, I lost in eight and six. Pretty easy. I actually played much better on this side also. So there isn't on the match before, it was the same thing. So it's a little bit, you always wonder about that. Is it the background? Is it the wind? Certainly the table is level. It's perfectly level, looks good. Here we go. Game five, two each. Oh, what a return by Steger. Another one, that's right on there. Oh. Blaszczyk's got a very nice hammer kill. Very nice hammer kill. You would expect nothing less from Mr. Intensity. Steger gets that whip across forehand. Sometimes he gets a massive spin on that ball. Unusual swing. Dead ball serve, but didn't get him much. Great return by Bastian. Backhand down the line. Beautiful. Quick. Right off the bounce. Big forehand right to the body. Lucjan trying to take it late. Couldn't quite get a good swing on it. Take those towel breaks, folks, when you're out there playing. You only get them every 6 points. If you miss one, it'll be on 12. Also a good time to be able to get your head together. Think about the next serve or maybe get your wind back, depending on your fitness. But more importantly, probably really just to think about what you want to do on your next serve or your next pattern or your next receive. Back and forth they go. Ping pong. Not much spin on that backhand loop. He just sort of gave him a throw. Oh, beautiful flip. Yep, side top. Side top, if they flip it, you can be in trouble. Yo! The re-loop twice in a row from off the table. To 287. Eight, I don't know, this match has gotten a little bit loose. It was pretty intense for a while. But now it seems like they lost it a little bit. Luke John seems like he's not playing with the intensity that we normally see here at the end of this game. Let's see. Yeah. And that one gets away. A gift. Maybe 150, 200 players watching this match. There's still some matches going on out there to 2300. Game six coming up. And that's a backhand down the line. Got to get on the inside of that ball and pick it up. Quick backhand of Steger. So quick, hardly ever misses a backhand. It's just always looking for it. Can change direction. Not as good a change of direction as Blaszczyk, but a little steadier. Blaszczyk got that nice one down the line. That's a tough ball to do. Five ball. Backhand stick. And get those soft loops that land short. Get in there and stick it hard. That ball moving forwards. There's that funky forehand loop by Steger. He sort of like lines up, holds his arm there, and then they all move like a piston or something. Okie doke, six all. Oh, he tries it around the net, hits the steel. You heard the dink. Blaszczyk looking great through game four. Some errors and lackadaisical play in game five, and now he's in trouble. And Jonas waiting for the final. Eight, seven. how many times do those lobs hit the edge? It seems more than should be. It's like the air sucks it towards the table and then dink. Eight, nine, good opening. He's got that nice backhand opening, hard to stop. The most impressive thing on these players is their short game technique. Oh, and then he almost missed the serve. That nice play, that nice drop shot. Most people say when you get the guy way back there, why don't you just drop it? It's not that easy. Because the arc of the ball is coming down. You got to make sure, because it bounces up higher. It goes more up than forward. And a lot of times you miss that drop shot. Oh, backhand to backhand war. Won by Blaszczyk. Are they going seven? Could be. A bit of a miss hit. 10-10. Thought maybe the ball cracked. Looked like it didn't fly properly. And match point for Steger. Excellent performance by Blaszczyk. Oh, it goes long. And the winner, Bastian Steger, into the final against Jonas.